Salutations, spook spirits and specters, and welcome back to Clannad. 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 Clannad? Clannad. So they were causing the Saison trouble because they wanted her to pay attention to them?
とにかくだ! てめえはここの寮生じゃないんだから。 今後ミサエさんに近づくんじゃねえぞ。
But I have to return her umbrella.
返事はどうした?
I still have to return her umbrella. She gave it to me. It's like a borrow. It's not a take. Yeah, I get it. There's no way for me to take on this many guys and win. I reply the way they want me to.
Yo, わかりゃいいんだ.
They all return to their rooms. The one I really feel bad for is Miss Saison. To spend every day surrounded by guys like that? Ugh. Ah, Illusionary World 3. Oh, look at that. I'm standing on a piece of earth as the wind howls by me. It feels as though it's blowing from the edge of the world, with nothing standing in its way. Even this body of mine can feel its strength. Countless lights dance on the earth, as if stirred by the wind. A girl is standing among them. They are stirred again, and many of the lights leap up from the ground. The girl looks up at them. This is the world I was born into. I think about how illusionary it is. Trees, grass, stones that roll by me, they all seem completely natural. They're supposed to be here. But what are the lights? I'm sure I hadn't known about this spectacle for a long time. The wind picks up again, and one of the lights passes by me. I try chasing after it. It's floating there, right within arm's reach. I reach out to it. The light slips through my fingers of junk. It's not like they'd be able to change anything, even if they could grab hold of it. I stand there, dumbfounded. The sight of the girl's shadow tells me that she's by my side, though. I point at one of the lights. "What is it?" the girl asks. I'm unable to answer. Does that light seem strange? I nod. What about the sky? I shake my head no. The ground? No. Just this light. I nod. Why could that be? The girl puts a hand to her chin as she thinks. I try to do the same. But the joints on my elbow don't bend that far. So I wait there, my arm bent unnaturally. She's always lived here. The light must be no different to her than my impression of the water and the trees. They're a part of nature. But they're the one thing I can't touch. Which makes me think that they must be shadows. But shadows are all cast by something, right? So where could that thing be? I look, but it's nowhere to be found. So that means, the girl begins, if we're able to think of something as strange, we know what normal looks like. Perhaps, I nod. I search the depths of my memories. One day, long ago, or maybe in the distant future, I'm not sure. I was in a different world. I remember the feeling of being there, but nothing else. Thinking about it warms the very bottom of my heart. What kind of place was it? I shake my head. Was it better than here? Probably. Did you like it there? I think. Was it less lonely than this place? The girl has always been alone. I've found out that this place really does have nothing. That it's a lonely place, devoid of fun. And that's why I was born here. That's right. This is a lonely world, isn't it? Hey, did you want to be born in this world? I'm unable to tell her my answer. I simply take her hand. That is my answer, I suppose. Sunday! I leave the house before noon, just like I would on a school day. Stepping over my indolent father's sleeping body on my way out. Yesterday's rain stopped overnight, and the ground is already dry. The sun shines gently on my face. Now then, what should I do? If I want to just laze around and kill time, where else is there to go but Sunohara's room? The sun may be shining gently, but that did not make a difference. On my way to the dorms...
Oi! そこのあんた! あんただよ!
Is he talking to me? I turn around to find a young man calling me over.
頼む!ちょっと来てくれ!
He's asking. Just ahead is a car, and right beside it, a man in overalls wearing a helmet. There's also a light pickup truck parked at the side of the road. Was there an accident?
こっちだ!ここを見てくれ!
The young man pointed at the hood of the car. When I come up closer and take a look, I see there's a round dent right in the center of the hood. And?
それで、その場で見上げたら、この作業員の兄ちゃんがいたってわけだ。
Okay. I look up. There's a ladder placed up against the streetlight. Maybe he was repairing the streetlight when it happened.
何度も言っているが、工具を落とすようなヘマはしない。もししていたとしてもだ。それを隠すような真似などしない。
Oh, really?
自分で気づかないミスだってあるでしょ?ねえ、あんたもそう思うだろ?
Me? The man looks over to me.
この人は俺の車の真上で作業してた。落としていないと言い張っているが、何かを落としたからこうしてボンネットがへこんでる。
Maybe it's always been there.
どっちが常識的か言ってやってくれよ。
I don't know.
さあねって。あんたも常識のない人間なのかい?まいったな。
That's what you get for asking a random stranger. To be honest, I really don't care either way. I'd never have come along with this guy if I'd known he was going to drag me into this.
じゃあ、あんたの会社に電話させてよ。事情説明するから。
Looks like he's got no need for me anymore. I take my leave without saying a word. The two men probably didn't notice. At the very least, they didn't call out to me. ラディディダタッタッタッ。Masae-san comes dashing over from an intersection of the building. And I'm all out of time. Uh-oh. Thank you all very much for watching. And ciao for now. Ciao for now.